Oh my god, is this the main character of the game? He has horrible stats. What?
Bruh.
Hello everyone, my name is Mecha, and you're watching Waifu, where we analyze interesting Fire Emblem units. What else did you think it meant? In these videos, I take a close look at units that I believe have the wrong reputation among Fire Emblem players, either because they're being overrated or underrated. I try to focus mostly on the gameplay, although sometimes story and character aspects come up as well. If there's another unit you'd like me to take a look at, please post them down in the comments below, and while you're there, don't forget to recruit the like button by turning it blue. Today, we're going to take a look at one of my favorite characters from my absolute favorite Fire Emblem game, Leaf from FE5. I think it's going to be interesting to analyze because throughout the years he's been both over and underestimated by FE5 players, so I'm going to try to paint a nuanced picture of how good Leaf actually is. Also, I apologize in advance if you pronounce the names in this video differently, like Leif and Leaf. He will always be Leaf to me, but I know Leif might technically be the right pronunciation. So, for the longest time, Leaf was considered one of the worst lords in the series, at least as far as his viability as a unit goes. His base stats make Roy look like Sigurd. He has 22 HP, 4 strength, a super low 2 skill, 5 speed, 6 luck, 3 defense, and 5 constitution. Those are just pathetic. From these stats alone, it looks like Leaf is slow, frail, and capable of doing very little damage. He looks especially bad compared to the units you start off with in Chapter 1, because all of them can one-round KO the generic enemies there. Orson, Halvan, Eivel, and Finn. Now, a lord that starts off weak is nothing new. Roy and Elliwood have the same problem, and they sort of overcome it eventually. Lord characters tend to have above average growth rates so that they can sort of turn into something, but Leaf's growth rates really are not that great. 35 strength and 40 speed is just mediocre at best. Of course, Thracia's growth rates just aren't that high to begin with, but when you've got bases this low, you would expect more. What really tends to salvage a Lord character is their promotion. Usually, Lords promote really late into the game and get some kind of super weapon to go along with it. This has worked really well for Roy in particular, who at least leaves players with a good final impression of him. Even though he spends most of the game hiding from enemies or getting ferried around, at least at the end of the game, he's got a cool and super strong flaming sword to kill enemies with. So you would expect a similar thing with Leaf, especially if you've got FE4 in the back of your mind. In that game, he's got the best promotion ever, promoting to the famous Master Knight class and getting a massive stat boost, a horse, and the ability to use almost every weapon, magic type, and staff in the game. It's the ultimate ascension. In this game, Leaf promotes, and pretty much nothing changes. He gains +1 in most of his stats, his sprite looks the same, and really the only benefit is accelerated EXP gain. It's a boost for sure, and it makes training him to be a viable combat unit for endgame a lot easier, but it's a far cry from his FE4 promotion. As for a super weapon, he gets the Blaggy Sword about 2-3 chapters before the end of the game, but it's only really useful for one very specific boss, and it's not even Leaf's personal weapon. 3 other characters can use it, and possibly better than he can as well. So with all of this in mind, Leaf looks like the ultimate terrible lord. Low bases, low growths, and no spectacular promotion or super weapon to look forward to. If you could bench him, you would. But fortunately for Leaf, Thracia is about so much more than stats in combat. In this game, there's a lot of other little things that units can be good at, and Leaf has got a lot of these little things. Plus, you'll find that his combat isn't as unsalvageable as his first impression makes it seem. The first thing that saves Leaf from bottom tier is the sword he inherits from his mom, the Lightbrand. I think it might just be the best early game weapon in the series, beating even the Wolfbeel and the Regin Leaf, considering just how much of a boost Leaf gets from using it. The most important aspect of the Lightbrand is its 1-2 range. Having 1-2 range instead of 1 range has so many benefits. It lets Leaf attack enemies without taking a counter, and it also lets him counter ranged enemies on enemy phase. It makes Leaf very flexible, there's a lot more places he can attack enemies from, and it's also much easier to protect him with other units that way. The Lightbrand is also a hybrid weapon. In melee combat it uses strength and hits on enemy defense, but at range it casts a spell. So you can switch depending on which way you would do more damage. Leaf's magic is obviously garbage, but so is enemy magic, which doubles as resistance in FE5, so generally he should be able to KO most enemies in 2 hits with a ranged attack. All of this makes it so much easier to feed kills to Leaf in the early game. The Lightbrand is pretty heavy with its 10 weight to the point where Leaf is weighed down by 5 points, leaving him with a big fat 0 attack speed if he uses it at base level. That kind of negates the whole point of getting a free +10 luck bonus if you're gonna cripple your avoid anyway, doesn't it? Now, he probably wasn't doubling much with an iron sword anyway, since even that weighs him down to 4, but it would be really good for Leaf if he could pick up some points of speed or constitution so that he can double armor knights. For this reason, Leaf is actually a really good candidate for the speed ring you get from a village in Chapter 2. With that, Leaf is able to double quite a bit more. Normally, speed rings or speed wings are heavily contested, but in this game, most characters have no doubling issues, and the few that do are probably beyond health. help anyway, or have access to some kind of brave weapon, so I think it's fair to grant Leaf that speed ring. So now we've established that Leaf has a good weapon, but that doesn't really make Leaf good. Thankfully, the light brand is just one item on a long list of things that he's got going for him, though it is one of the biggest. The other big thing that works in Leaf's favor is his availability. Leaf is the only unit in the game that's available from start to finish. You can count on him helping you out in every single map. Not even the other units that join in Chapter 1 can boast this due to the Manster arc, which I won't go into detail about just in case you still have to play the game. Play it, by the way, it's good. But in fact, being the lord of the story, Leaf is force deployed on every map. This is definitely a positive for him, as it means he doesn't cost you a deployment slot, ever. It can be a bit annoying that you cannot change his starting position at all, but in the maps where his starting position really matters, he starts in the best possible spot, so I don't think it's worth complaining about. It's also nice that Leaf will not fatigue no matter how much you use him, which can make him useful to soak up attacks from ballistas. When given the speed ring, Leaf is one of your better units in the Manster arc. The combination of 1 to range and 6 movement indoors is unique to him in Chapter 4. Only in Chapter 4X do you get Asphel, a unit with the same perks. Leaf can potentially be your best combat unit in these maps if you're willing to invest more early game stat boosters into him, because aside from the speed ring I mentioned, there's a life ring for plus 7 HP and a shield ring for plus 2 defense. It's commonly advised to give these other stat boosters to Leaf as well, so that he can really shine during Manster and after that. This also makes it easier to give more XP to Leaf in general, maybe make use of some of those growth boosting scrolls, but even with all that favoritism, I've always found Leaf kind of lacking in the mid game. He's okay, but his lack of a promotion really holds him back. He doesn't really one-round KO enemies very much after Manster, so there's not much of a point in sending him to the front lines all the time. Asphel, on the other hand, is your best offensive unit, especially with 1-2 range, and with these stat boosters, he has the ability to take hits. You can use those stat boosters to get himself into more risky situations, like areas with high enemy density or powerful bosses. Or if you don't want a godly Asphel, then there's probably someone else who's worth giving these stat boosters to. What Leaf is much better at is being a supportive unit in the mid game. I mean that literally, he has the highest number of supports in the game. Supports in Thracia are not conversations, but rather hidden passive bonuses between certain units. Sometimes they're mutual, sometimes they just work one way. Leaf has a massive 16 of these, whereas the usual amount of supports is somewhere between 1 and 3. In fact, most characters don't support anyone at all. Leaf supports give these 16 characters a nice bonus of 10 to their hits, avoid, crit, and crit avoid when they're within 3 tiles of him. For some of these, that's really useful. Finn, Nana, Ava, and Asphel in particular are really strong characters that almost any player uses, and increasing their reliability in combat can be very nice. And even the more mediocre units like Hix, Selfina, Olwen, and Carrion can definitely use the boost. Same goes for Dashin and Miranda, if they're being used. And of course, it makes Ronan a lot more godly, can't forget about that one. A couple of the supports don't really do anything. Safi, Tina, Lenoan, and Sarah will probably spend most of the time away from combat, using those broken Thracia staffs, often from long range. Staffs can miss in Thracia, but supports won't increase your accuracy with them. As if that is not enough, Leaf also has leadership stars. He can have 0, 1, or 2, depending on where you're at in the story, and each star gives 3% hit and avoid to every unit you deploy, no matter how far away they are from Leaf. As much as I like this bonus, I'm not sure whether we can really count it as a contribution by Leaf. You cannot undeploy him, so it's literally always there, even if you never do anything with Leaf himself. At least with other units with leadership stars, you have to actively choose to deploy them. It's the most passive bonus to ever exist. They are on Leaf's status screen, but they might as well be like FE7's tactician stars. Always in effect, and not on any particular unit at all. Speaking of bonuses that I'm not sure if they count, we need to discuss the Kingmaker. This is a weapon that you receive about halfway through the game, and it's really good. It's a reasonably strong and light C-rank Brave sword that gives the wielder charm. Just like Nana, that means the holder gives anyone within 3 squares 10% hit and avoid. This weapon is really good, and it works well on Leaf. You can stack it with his support bonus as well as Nana's charm and her support bonus if applicable. Very useful if you want to make Finn basically invincible. Leaf is definitely the best user of the Kingmaker, but again, I gotta question if we can really attribute the Kingmaker's utility to Leaf. It's not his personal weapon, in fact it's the opposite. Anyone with seized swords can use it, that's part of what makes it so great. The charm bonus could be given out by any other recently experienced sword user. Leaf also has the Adept skill, which occasionally lets him strike again with a proc chance equal to his attack speed. Early game, this is a very low activation rate because of his low base speed and tendency to lose attack speed from just about everything, but later on it might occasionally help you. In FE4, Adept was much better because it had an attack speed plus 20% activation rate, and units just have more speed in general, but in this game, it's not something you can ever really rely on. So sometimes he just unexpectedly gets an attack in, and that's about it. The same goes for his movement star. Leaf has one of those, so he has a 5% chance to move again. You will generally play as if Leaf isn't gonna activate it, so when you get one, you might not be able to really make use of it, but there will be times where it's useful, I guess. The last small advantage that Leaf has that we can briefly discuss is the Blaggy Sword. This sword is given to you by Sias at the end of the game to kill Raedric with. It's tailor-made to slay him. It negates the damage-halving effect of his Lapto Sword, and also deals effective damage, since it doubles as an armor slayer. However, Fergus, Nana, and Dermot can also use it, and depending on who you've been training, they might be better at doing so. So, just like with the Kingmaker, it's something nice that Leaf can do, but if he's not doing it, then someone else probably is. So, as you can see, Leaf is far more than just a bad lord, like his stats would suggest. IP5 just has a lot of other little things that impact how good a character is, and Leaf has a little bit of everything. It's understandable that at first people really didn't see those things as very relevant, and just looked at Leaf's poor combat at base, and they were like, bad lord. On the other hand, I don't think it's fair to say that Lightbrand plus Blaggysword plus Adept plus Leadership Stars plus Movement Star plus 60 Supports plus only unit that can't fatigue is Prunich Incarnate. Some of these little advantages are just that, tiny little things that either don't really count as an advantage for Leaf, or things that are luck-based and unlikely to help when you really need them, and things you'd have even without Leaf, that makes Leaf a very hard unit to evaluate. The first Thracia tier list made on the Fire Emblem subreddit about a year ago put Leaf as the 9th best unit in the game, and the more recent one from about 4 months ago put him in the second highest tier, A rank, leaving only the 9 units in S rank above him. This put Leaf in the same tier as some really strong and useful units like Orson, Finn, Nana, and Dean. And there were also way more votes to put him even higher up in the S rank tier than there were votes for him to be put lower in the B rank tier. If you want my overall opinion, I think Leaf as a unit is good but not great. Assuming he's being given some kind of stat booster, preferably the speed ring, he's great in Master and at least helpful in every other map that isn't just being warp skipped. He might only contribute a little bit in each map, but that adds up to a big positive. His biggest perks, aside from his availability, are definitely the Lightbrand and his supports to Finn, Nana, and Aspel, as he makes these great units more reliable at what they do in certain situations. I would definitely recommend anyone playing FE5 to use Leaf. He needs a little bit of handholding at times, but he's definitely not a liability like a couple of the other lords. And that's gonna be it for this episode of Waifu. I hope you enjoyed it. Feel free to warp skip straight to the comment section if there's any other unit, overrated or underrated, that you'd like me to take a look at. And if you had a good time, make sure to seize the like and subscribe buttons. Also, you may notice that this video is particularly handsome looking. That will be the doing of my editor Hoshi the Hero, so shoutouts to him for that. And the thumbnail is of course made by Rin, so you can find links to both of them in the description below. Peace out. Bye.